In this video, we will cover how to render and export images in Substance 3D Stager. Once you have set up your scene, you can move from the Design tab to the Render tab. Here, you will see a selection of settings you can adjust to get your desired output. Firstly, you can choose between CPU rendering or GPU rendering. If your computer's GPU is supported, GPU rendering is usually faster. It's up to you which you choose. There is no visual or quality difference between them. You can then adjust the quality settings. Stager has helpful presets for these, so you don't have to spend time changing each setting individually. The higher the quality and resolution of the output image, the longer the render will take. You can also set a maximum time Stager will spend rendering your scene in these settings. This is great for getting the best render you can within set time constraints. After that, you can go to the left panel and select which cameras you want to render with and make some override adjustments if needed. You can then give your image a name and pick where to save it. You can also select what format to export your render as. PNGs are great, but what is unique about Stager is that it can export your renders as a 16-bit PSD file, also known as a Photoshop file. This Photoshop file then contains multiple layers. Let's switch to Photoshop to look at our PSD render. You can see that not only do you get a final rendered image, but you also get multiple layers that help you make post-process adjustments. These include the rendered image without a background, so background color can be changed easily. This also includes a depth pass and a selection of masks that mask out components by object or material. These can be helpful when wanting to adjust a specific part of the image, but not the rest. Now you know how to get the best out of your renders in Stager. We look forward to seeing what you can create.